Thank you for joining me once again on today's edition of Word of Life. And this is episode 14, series 6. We are so blessed to be on this series. We are still treating the topic that we are still on, that we entitled Learning to Forgive. Learning to Forgive. You know, I deliberately stick on this series for some time now because, you know, the major thing in the Christendom is forgiveness. Forgiveness is the major thing that we have in the Christendom. And without forgiveness, Christianity is not a Christianity. Without forgiveness, we can't call ourselves Christians. Because we have been forgiven, that is why we have the opportunity, we have the chance to become children of God, because our sins have been forgiven. You can never live to the expectation of God. You can never live on this earth to be perfect without Him forgiving you all your sins. Therefore, He also instructed us in His word to forgive all those who wrong us, so that we can also choose to practice what He has done for us. Shall we pray? Dear Lord, we thank you so much. We bless you for this opportunity to meet here once again. We thank you for your presence among us. We believe that you are going to expound more of this truth unto us. We love you and thank you for loving us more. In Jesus' most excellent name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now, as believers, we are always instructed to live in peace with all men. Follow peace with all men, holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. If it is possible, let us live in peace with every man. The Bible instructs us in every way to live in peace with all men. And remember, it is an instruction, not a suggestion. God has instructed us. He instructed believers in His word to live in peace, to follow peace with every man. God is not suggesting to believers to live, to choose to live in peace with people or not. It is an instruction. So even though we are not under the Old Testament law, in the New Testament, even the instructions that God has given us, they are even more than the Old Testament laws. So we have this instruction to live in peace with everyone. And that is the character of God. That is the nature of the gospel. That is the nature of the gospel that we preach. Therefore, it must reflect in the life of Christians, in the life of believers. Let's look at a few scriptures. Romans chapter 12, verse 18. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, as much as lieth in you as a believer. How much does it light in you at all times? It lights in you to live in peace, to live peaceably with all men. It lights in you at all times because you have the fruits of the Holy Spirit. One of the fruits of the Holy Spirit that God has given to a believer is peace. So once you are a believer, you have the peaceable spirit. And therefore, you have to choose to live in peace with all men. And that is possible. So long as you are a believer, you must live in peace with every man. It is possible. Let them do whatever they want to do wrong against you. You live in peace with everyone. You choose from your heart. You are not going to hate anybody. You are not going to be in grudge or live in grudge with anybody. So whatever they do, you choose to live in peace with everyone. Let's again look at Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. It says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. God is instructing you as a believer to live in peace with all men. Let all men live in strife. You, a believer, live in peace. Choose to follow peace. Let others be rough against you. Choose to follow peace. At a time, certain things unbelievers may do may put you off to the extent that even if you hurt them, you are still right. But God says, choose to live. Choose to follow the peaceable way. Choose to follow peace with all men and live in holiness. In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 10, the Bible says, we have been sanctified. We have been made holy once and for all. Who has sanctified us? God. God chose to sanctify us. To sanctify means to be made holy. So as a believer, you have been made holy. You have been sanctified. Because God knows that you cannot make yourself holy. No one can make himself holy. You cannot sanctify yourself. Therefore, he put it upon himself. He chose to make you holy. He chose to sanctify you by the body of Christ, by the offering of the body of Christ, once and for all. So you have to choose to live in the holiness that God has put you in. The holiness that God has set you in, you have to follow that holiness. You have to choose to live in that holiness and live peaceably with all men. Let's again look at Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26, 27, and 31. It says, be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Hallelujah. Be ye angry. Yes, you can be angry because anger goes with the heart. Something that the heart is not happy about, it gets angry about it. But sin not. In your anger, sin not. You don't have to sin. Now you have to take note that there is just a thin line between your anger and your sin. Once you're angry, you are likely to make a comment that will become a sin. An angry person will end up hurting. An angry person may end up insulting, and that is already a sin. An angry person may end up hating people, and that is a sin. An angry person may end up doing a whole lot of things because of anger. So if you're angry, you don't have to sin in your anger. And let not the sun go down upon your wrath. Now, take note of this. Apart from the normal 24 hours today, the sun goes down, then we have the evening. That's not the only time when the sun goes down in one's anger, as the Bible is talking to. You can be in grudge with someone today, then tomorrow you die. When you die, the sun has gone down in your anger. You can be quarreling with someone today, and tomorrow the person passes on. The sun has gone down in his anger, in your anger, or in your wrath. And this is also what the Bible is talking about. Once the person dies, there's no place for forgiveness in his heart again. And once the person dies, you have no chance to forgive the person again. So you don't have to let the sun go down in your wrath. So whatever someone does wrong against you, if you like, you tell the person and you forgive the person. And if you like, you just let it go. You forgive the person. Don't let the sun go down in your anger, upon your wrath. Do not let the sun go down. And the most dangerous aspect is that you don't know when you will die. You don't know when the person will die. So you learn to forgive always and at all times. Neither give place to the devil. Anytime you give a foothold to the devil, he takes a stronghold. So you don't have to give any place to the devil in your life. Don't leave any chance for the devil to enter into your life to use you. And that might be very dangerous. And verse 31 says, let all bitterness and all wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you. That is not your nature. That is not the nature of a child of God. So you cannot portray that life. If you are a child of God and you are still living such life, you are living beside yourself. That is not your nature. You are acting beside yourself. That is not your true nature. You need to live in peace with all men. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 3. For ye are yet carnal. For whereas there is among you envy and strife and divisions, are ye not carnal and walk as men? Even in the church, if you have envy, if you have a pastor envying another pastor, if you have a church member envying another church member, if you have strife and you have divisions among you, you are still carnal. You may be the best preacher among all of them in the church, but you are still living carnal. Once you have envy among you, once you have division among you, once you have strife, you are living a carnal life and you walk as men. You can be the best praise singer to the Lord, but once you have division and you have envy and you have strife among you, you are still living a carnal life and you are walking as men. And God is instructing you, do not let this carnality live in you as a child of God. James chapter 3 verse 15 and 16. This wisdom descended not from above, but is earthly, sensual, and devilish. For where envy and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. When there is envy, where there is strife, the devil gives you work. The devil assigns work to your brain because of strife, because of envy, because of anger. So you learn to forgive people no matter the issue. Let's look at verse 14 and 17 of that same scripture.